الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين، رحمة الله العالمين، سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، سبحانك ربنا لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا رب العالمين. Dear brothers and sisters, first of all, I want to express my happiness to be with you this night, inshallah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of you and your families and increase your knowledge and accept all acts of worship, inshallah. I will try, inshallah, to talk to you in this few minutes, inshallah, about Islam, our great religion. Islam, in fact, is the greatest blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us in our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us a lot of blessings. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us hearing, sight, health, wealth, a lot of blessings. But the greatest blessing ever is Islam, is our religion. Islam is the greatest religion, is the greatest blessing. الإسلام أعظم نعمة أنعم الله سبحانه وتعالى بها علينا. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول وإن تعدوا نعمة الله لا تحصوها. Allah says in his sacred book, if you try to number Allah's blessings upon you, you could never be able to number it. You could never be number it. But the greatest blessing ever is Islam. So this is our duty in our life. In fact, to express our gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this greatest blessing, for our being a Muslim. This blessing, in fact, requires something of gratefulness, gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how to do that? How to do that? How to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is a main question for all of us. In our life, we see different people, a different thinking, different thoughts. I cannot say different religions, because the only correct religion, the only religion is Islam. الدين واحد وهو الإسلام كما قال الله تعالى إن الدين عند الله الإسلام. So we have to express gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this great blessing. I will tell you about some things, some points that will help us to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this great blessing for Islam. The first point is adherence to Islam, to adhere to this religion, to adhere to Islam, and to endure all hardships that may meet us in our life, that we may face our life. التمسك بالإسلام التمسك بهذا الدين الذي أنعم الله سبحانه وتعالى به علينا، والصبر على الأذى فيه، والصبر على الأذى فيه. To abide by Islam, adhere to Islam, and to endure all hardships, all obstacles that may face in your life. To be patient, to have patience in your life, in all your acts of worship, in all your deeds, to do it for the sake of Allah with patience. التمسك بالإسلام والصبر على الأذى فيه. This is a main point. The second main point is to call for Islam. Calling for Islam. الدعوة إلى الله عز وجل. Calling for Islam. To invite others to Islam. To introduce Islam to others. This is our duty. All of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask all of us. Not only imams or ulama or shuyukh. No. All of us, we have this responsibility. We are responsible for Islam. This is the main responsibility in our life. To call for Islam. To invite others to Islam. So Allah says in Quran, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين. الله سبحانه وتعالى commands his beloved messenger محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم to say قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله. Say يا محمد, say this is our way. هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله. I call for الله سبحانه وتعالى. I and also all my followers. I call for Islam by wisdom, by insight. Calling for Islam by wisdom and insight and good manners. ادعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. So our brothers and sisters, this is our duty in our life. If we know that Islam is the greatest blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us, so we have to show and express gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessing. First, by adherence to Islam and to endure all hardships that may face us in our life. Second point is to call for Islam, to introduce Islam to others, introduce Islam to all the world. الدعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. These are two main points. This in addition to our duties as Muslims, our duties to establish pillars of Islam, to Islam establish all pillars of Islam, arkan al-Islam, pillars of Islam, as well as arkan al-Iman, pillars of faith, pillars of Islam, as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا. To testify that there is no God but Allah and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. To establish your prayer. To establish your prayers. To fast Ramadan, to give zakat, to go for Hajj. So to establish your pillars of Islam and also pillars of Iman, pillars of Iman, pillars of faith, as also our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. الإيمان أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. When Jibreel asked the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم about إيمان, what is إيمان, ما الإيمان, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم replied أن تؤمن بالله, to believe in Allah, the Almighty, to believe in Allah. And his angels, and his sacred books, divine books, divine revelations, أن تؤمن بالله, وملائكته وكتبه, and his messengers, ورسله, واليوم الآخر, the last day, وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره, and to believe in the divine decree, good or bad, وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. So this also one of the main points that we by it we will express our gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being a Muslim, to establish pillars, all pillars of Islam beside all pillars of faith. And we try to do our best to reach the third degree or the third level, and in fact it is the highest level for you as Muslim, to try as much as possible to do your best to reach إحسان. الإحسان after Islam and Iman there is إحسان. الإحسان كما عرفه رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, as our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم defined it in his long hadith with Jibreel عليه السلام, الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. الإحسان تورشيب الله سبحانه وتعالى as if you see Allah, as if you see him, and if you don't see him, he definitely sees Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So in all our life, in all our acts of life, we have to know that Allah سبحانه وتعالى sees us and knows everything about us, in public or secretly or hiddenly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees us and knows everything. So you have to know this and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to this and try to reach the level of ihsan. So this also one of the main points we have to do to express, to show our gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being a Muslim, to establish pillars of Islam as it should be, to establish pillars of faith, arkan al-iman, as it should be, and try as much as possible to reach the level of ihsan, and this is the highest level. This is the highest level for every believer. For every believer. In fact, our my dear brothers and sisters, Islam is a moderate religion. Islam is a religion of moderation. Islam is a universal religion. So, when we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we try to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to know the meaning of worship, the meaning of this word, ibadah, the meaning of ibadah, ma'na al-ibadah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us only for his worship,
to worship Him.
This is the main purpose for which Allah created all of us. The main purpose.
العبادة كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
Allah says I have created jinn and man only to worship me. وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون.
So from this point we want to know the meaning of worship. The meaning of worship.
This word means that all your acts of worship, all your deeds, all your things must be directed only to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala. Must be directed to Allah alone.
أن تعني أن كل ما يحبه الله سبحانه وتعالى ويرضاه من الأقوال والأفعال الظاهرة والباطنة لا بد أن يوجه إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى، لا بد أن يصرف إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى.
All what Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves from deeds deeds, sayings, anything you intend to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with it or by it, you have to intend that this is directed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. This is the meaning of ibadah. This is the meaning of worship. Otherwise, any act of worship will be refused, will be invalid, will be considered as shirk. أسأل الله أن يعيذنا وإياكم من الشرك.
So you have to consider all your life is for Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
This word worship in Islam not only means pillar of Islam. The prayers, fasting, zakat, hajj, pillars of Islam only. No, all your acts of life, all your acts of worship in your life may be considered as worship, may be considered as ibadah. If you intend by it the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, your food, your drink, your sleeping, your studying, anything you do, your marriage, your, if you intend by this act the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, you have food to have strength to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to work, to go in helping others, assisting others, and like this, drinking also, if you marry, want to marry, because this will prevent you from falling in unlawful relationships, and like this. So by this, your act now will be considered as worship, because you mean by it the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your intention is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your life. So this will be considered as worship. This is the meaning of worship. So this word is a comprehensive term. In fact, it's a comprehensive term. It comprises all your acts as a Muslim. When you greet others, Muslims or non-Muslims, when you give advice for any brother or sister, giving advice, when you smile, you're smiling in front of, in front of others, you're smiling, yani anything you do will be considered as worship as long as you do it
for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you can imagine how great is our religion, to what extent our religion is great. And so and for this I want to talk to you about Islam and to remind you, we all know, but from time to time we have to remind each other, we have to remember this greatest blessing in our life, the blessing of Islam, the blessing of being Muslims. So also two main points I want to tell you about it: pillars and conditions of worship. Pillars and conditions of worship. Arkan al-ibadah wa shurut al-ibadah. Pillars of any act of worship. Any act of worship must be consist of two main points. The first point is kamal al-dhul wa al-khawf min Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Complete humility and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the first pillar. The second pillar is kamal al-hubb lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Complete love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you direct in act of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to remember these two main pillars. Complete humility. Complete humility and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كمال الذل الخوف من الله سبحانه وتعالى. Submission to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And also don't forget love. Love, complete love for Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So we can understand from these two main pillars that humility or fear without love, no, not will be accepted. Not will be unacceptable. And also loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without fearing of Him also يعني not acceptable. So you have to combine both complete humility and fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same time. These are the pillars of ibadah, of worship. Conditions of worship. Any act of worship also should combine two main conditions. The first condition is sincerity to Allah, al-ikhlas lillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second condition is following the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Following the sunnah of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, in any act of worship, you want to do any act of worship, you have to remember these two conditions. Because, unfortunately, a lot of our brothers and sisters, they want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know that their intention is good, is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Niyyah khalisa. And as the Prophet, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. Acts are only by intention. Innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. Wa innama likulli imri'in ma nawa. And everyone will have what he intended. Innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. Wa innama likulli imri'in ma nawa. Walakin. But we have to remember how to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This isn't a difficult. This is, inshaAllah, an easy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes easy for us. هَذَا الدِّينُ يُسْرٌ وَلَيْسَ عُسْرٌ كَمَا أَخْبَرَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِنَّ الدِّينَ يُسْرٌ وَلَيْسَ عُسْرٌ وَلَكِنْ But what we want in this life, in our life, is to follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the main conditions in act of worship, the sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ikhlas, you do any act of worship only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also to follow the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I remember one time, one brother and sister, one husband, he yani met me to he seeks my assistance to help him in a problem with his wife. One problem in his family, and he told me to try to help him to solve this problem. So I asked him one question. You will accept the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will accept it. You want me to judge according to the Quran, according to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I found him for, meanwhile, he became silent. Like, yani, he was astonished. Maybe because he knows that the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the judgment of his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we are far, unfortunately, as Muslims in nowadays, we are far, little bit far. إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبُّكَ. Alhamdulillah, mashallah, we have a lot of Muslims everywhere. Alhamdulillah, they are adhering to the Quran and the Sunnah. But at the same time, we have to tell the fact, this is the truth. Many people, many Muslims are far. They want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by their mind, as their mind directs them. And this is incorrect. In fact, we have to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as Allah ordered us, as Allah commanded us, and as His Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taught us in His Sunnah, and according to His companions and followers. Otherwise, we will be in a danger. So, when I told this brother, I will judge according to the... So, after this, he accepted. Because in many cases, some of our brothers, they give judgment according to what we call urf, according to our habits, our traditions, our cultures, and we forget our great book, our Quran, and our guidance, our Sunnah, the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is my advice to you in this night, to know the meaning of worship, and also to know the pillars of worship, and also conditions of worship, sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and following the guidance of his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at the end of this lecture today, I want to say to all of you, Jazakumullah khair for giving me this opportunity to give you this few minutes and to give you this guidance. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of your efforts, inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن ينفعنا بما علمنا وأن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن يزيدنا علما. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم اجعل جمعنا هذا جمعا مرحوما مغفورا، واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا، وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان، واجعلنا من الراشدين. اللهم اجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا، ونور صدورنا، جلاء أحزاننا، وذهاب همومنا وغمومنا. اللهم اجعل بركاته علينا وعلى آبائنا وعلى أمهاتنا وعلى أزواجنا وعلى أولادنا وعلى جميع المسلمين والمسلمات. المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء والأموات إنك ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.